Mag ik het?
I have to say, Minister, that I think it is a shameful decision of the government to decide not to support a bill tonight to insert the right to housing into the Constitution. In doing that, you are ignoring the views of the Simon community, of Peter McVerry, of the Children's Rights Alliance, of the Mercy Law Centre, and the Constitutional Convention, which voted by 84% to insert the right to housing into the Constitution. But it appears, in the face of the worst housing and homelessness emergency in the history of the state, an emergency generated by 6 years of failed, misguided policies by Fine Gael governments, that you know better than Simon, than Peter McVerry, than the Children's Rights Alliance, all the housing NGOs, and indeed the Constitutional Convention. Even the Taoiseach's new best pal, Justin Trudeau, the Prime Minister of Canada, is about to bring forward a right to housing into Canadian law. 81 other countries in the world have it. But no, the Irish government, in the face of an absolutely catastrophic housing emergency, will not put our basic right to secure, affordable, dignified housing into our constitution so that it is a right for every resident of this country to have a home. And as our bill proposes, that it should be a requirement and an obligation on all governments to vindicate that right to housing through the allocation of resources and through its policies. And yet you have set your face against that, and it seems rather than establish the right to housing, which we so desperately need, you want to bury it in another committee reject the advice of those who know and who are working on the front line. Now, I want to make it clear, Minister, I do not believe, and no one who advocates inserting the right to housing into the Constitution believes, it is the panacea for all aspects of this current crisis. We have been saying to you, to Fine Gael, since 2011, that the answer to the housing crisis that we could see was even building up at that point is to have an emergency programme of public housing construction, to have used compulsory purchase powers to get hold of vacant properties and building land that is being hoarded for use for public and affordable housing, to use NAMA as a vehicle to deliver social and affordable housing using its land, its assets and its cash, to stop all economic evictions and repossessions, to guarantee security of tenure to people privately renting, and to introduce effective rent controls that actually ensure affordable rents. For 7 years we have been saying this. For 7 years your government, the previous Fine Gael-led government, ignored this advice, did exactly the opposite, abandoned the construction of council housing, used NAMA to flog off tens of billions of land, housing and assets to vulture funds who are now evicting people. You have allowed economic evictions to continue unabated, mortgage repossessions to happen in huge numbers, for rents to spiral out of control and out of the affordability of huge numbers of our citizens. You have done all of these things in the face of a growing crisis and against the pleas of those involved in housing and indeed ourselves and others in the opposition here. Those are the measures that are necessary. But as well as those, everybody who works in this area has said inserting the right to housing into the Constitution would make a substantial difference. The Mercy Law Centre say a right to housing in the Constitution would mean that the courts could look at the state decision or policy as to whether it was proportionate by reference to that right. It would mean that government and state policies and actions would have to respect the right. Legislation and policy would have to be proof to ensure they reasonably protect the right to housing. It would mean that the policies in relation to housing and homelessness could not be a political whim, but would have to have this grounding, this obligation to respect the right to housing. Had that been in the Constitution since 2011, you could not have made the desperate mistakes that you have made, and we would not be in the mess that we are currently in. So there is absolutely no case for not supporting this bill. And I really have to ask, Minister, what has your government got against rights for citizens? And for that matter, if Fianna Fáil don't back it, I will ask them the same question. You won't ratify the rights for the UN Convention for the People of Rights, rights for people with disabilities. You don't want to give women the right to control their own bodies and their own fertility and their own medical treatment. And you don't want to give people the right to housing. Fianna Fáil in 2000... as much as all of you praise the European Union, you're going to roll out the red carpet now for Mr. Verhofstadt tomorrow. You're always talking about how you love the European Union, but when the European Union proposes rights, you don't want nothing to do with them. So the Social Charter, for example, the European Social Charter in the year 2000 proposed a right to housing. Ireland sought an opt-out. That was Fianna Fáil. I'm not sure if Fine Gael raised objections at the moment. We specifically opted out of the European Charter obligation of the right to housing. Why? Why? And of course the answer is because at every hand's turn you have protected the interests of developers, of speculators, of vulture funds, instead of vindicating the rights of citizens to a secure, affordable roof over their head, and we're in a mess because of it. Will you please change tack, and as a first step, support this bill and change the Constitution to establish that right to housing in law?
Okay, Grimago Tlaskian Corla. The Taoiseach talked earlier today about the progress that's been made in dealing with the housing crisis and sounded very proud indeed of the government's achievements. He's bound to say these things, but I think we need a reality check in this House. The housing solutions, which have included everything from family hubs, emergency accommodation, contracting out the state's responsibility to house its citizens to private landlords at huge cost to the state and uncertainty for tenants. And that progress sees more need, more suffering, more distress, and indeed, as winter approaches, more fear as a result of your government's failure, not your success. Over 100,000 on the waiting list and over 8,000 in homeless accommodation. One of the more amusing narratives is to suggest that in dealing with the housing crisis, we haven't been able to completely solve it because there's a minority government, and if only we had a strong majority government, we could sort it all out. The reality is that we do have a majority government. It's one led by Fine Gael and propped up at every hand's turn by Fianna Fáil. And the housing crisis persists because we do not have the political will to solve it. It persists because groups and individuals who support those parties that form the backbone of those parties, to whose class they owe allegiance, are doing very well out of this crisis. Thank you very much. This is the fourth piece of legislation that our group has put before this House to try and deal with the crisis. We proposed changing the remit of NAMA to provide social and affordable housing and to stop selling off land and public housing. That was rejected by this House and by the government. We proposed an anti-eviction bill to keep people in their homes, and that was rejected by this House. There was a tied vote, in fact, and the Ciaran Corla used his casting vote to scupper that bill. We proposed a rent control bill that would reduce rents to the rate they were at in 2011, where most workers' wages were at, and to control the rampant profiteering of landlords and REITs and vulture funds. And that was rejected by this House and by the government. We are now proposing to give citizens a constitutional right to decent housing and to join other European countries like Belgium, Finland, Greece, the Netherlands, Portugal, Spain, Sweden. Around the world, the right to housing is included in 81 constitutions. So what's wrong with this little country with one of the fastest growing economies and one of the biggest housing crises ever? Why haven't failed to get this house to reduce rents, to prioritise the building of social housing and to stop evictions, have we now turned to putting the right of housing into the constitution? Because at every debate, the adherence of the free market in this house, the adherence of private property rights, have told us that our proposals are unworkable, unconstitutional, would be struck down by the courts and would result in the ghettos of poor people that might even increase, and that we would be breaching EU fiscal rules. So this is an attempt to scupper those excuses which are really masking what Fianna Fáil and Fine Gael constantly do, and that is to back up the builders, the developers, the corporate landlords, the speculators, who all form the backbone of their party allegiance. And this is a fig leaf to justify a policy that people living in hotels or B&Bs are allowed to stay there in one room just like they did in 1913. This crisis has over 100,000 in housing need and on the social housing list, but it also sees, on the other side of it, some people doing it very, very well out of it. The three main owners of Cairn Homes make 20 million from selling their shares in their company, now valued at over 1 billion euro. And this year they built 100 homes. Last year they built just 90. The crisis allowed these rich people to accumulate so much wealth that they now own 20% of zoned development land in Dublin. And it means that they can buy 9 acres of prime land in RTE for 1 million euro. Cairn, like other developers, are not in the business of meeting housing needs, and they do not, as the Taoiseach stated earlier today, build homes. Their concern is to make profits, and that actually means that it's not in their interest to see this housing crisis solved, or indeed to build homes on the scale that they are needed, and certainly not social and affordable housing. Equally, we have 8,000 homeless, and we have people dying in tragic circumstances on the streets, record rising rents, and landlords using loopholes to evict people and raise rents beyond the levels that are tolerable. And we have boom times for estate agents, for REIT companies, and we can see affordable student accommodation now coming on stream at 250 euro a week. So giving all citizens a constitutional right to a home will not solve this crisis overnight, and we're not claiming that it will. Of course it won't. But it will remove the fake arguments put up here and put up in the media to explain why we cannot invest and build public housing. Arguments that property rights mean that we can't control rents, that fiscal rules preclude serious state investment to provide massive public housing, would be scuppered if we had a right to housing enshrined in the Constitution. I want to finish by commenting on something the Taoiseach said today, which really struck me as incredible, because it shows the level of ignorance and the sheer class bias around this issue and the concept of public and social housing. He said, Mr. Varadkar said today, he's opposed to giving everyone a house for free. That's a dig at those who live in social housing. And it's a dig that shows his ignorance and his class bias, because nobody gets a house for free. Those who live in social housing pay a differential rate, in case the Taoiseach didn't know that this is actually the reality, and his own stupidity or class bias is blinding him to the reality. So we do need to build mass numbers of good quality public housing that we can finance and ensure that it's not just the poorest who have no option nowadays, Minister. It is all sorts of people. It is people who have good jobs. It is people who want to buy a home but have no option. It is people that we constantly hear as witnesses to that situation on the radio. This is not about the poorest of the poor or those who lived in the squalor of the ghettos of 1913. This is about a lot of ordinary, average earning workers. And it's now clear that the market will never provide decent, affordable accommodation for the majority of our citizens to live with dignity. This bill would allow the state to prioritise it in a way that it has never done in history, and to see housing as a fundamental human right, not left to the market or to the whims of those seeking the maximum profit, but left to the state to actually provide it as a human need. This bill will prioritise the needs of housing over the owners of companies like Cairns or Iris, or the multitude of vested interests whose wealth is growing on the backs of the misery that this crisis produces.